It's okay to feel this way in the morning when boulders and landslides have covered you in your sleep and the sun is burning you before it has even started to rise, before the freeway is jammed and the children are crying for milk. It's okay to feel this way in the morning when you forgot to pray and you stumble out the door with foggy interest and your feet have a difficult time moving. It's okay to feel this way in the morning when the battle for life has been keeping score and tallying the losses on your chalkboard soul. It's okay to feel this way in the morning. Play your harp, play your part, and get moving. It's okay. I've been storing my fears and my worries in a honey jar I keep in my stomach, where flies gather and breed, where alley cats pick the flesh off of bones, where manuscripts full of dreams are thrown out and burned. I remind the sweet Lord I have a Bible on my nightstand, next to the reading light that collects dust on the shade, next to the empty water glasses, next to charms, amulets, gemstones, tarot cards, star charts, Buddhist prayers, and a houseplant that's my only friend. I ponder all of these things and realize that loneliness is only a misunderstanding between the heart and soul, and suddenly I feel a little less lonely as I dip my fingers in the honey jar and go to sleep. Cry, my city beloved, weeping like the crucifix hanging in the cathedral of Our Lady of Angels, because Lord knows we all need saving. Eyeballs in a tin can, washed away like ruins. Corporate retreats, civic functions, mitosis, financial stress, retirement parties, addicts in the alley, traffic jams, organic foods only, OnlyFans, Botox as a status symbol, poor infrastructure, drugs available on every corner, names on a billboard, aliases painted in the alley, designer cars, designer clothes, good weather, bad air. This is only 2 minutes of my time on a Tuesday afternoon in LA, and for some odd reason it feels like home, as I remind myself that even the devil was once an angel. Had but sadness painted twilight perpetual upon you this morning, I would have found the grandeur slightly disturbing. Please don't misunderstand me when I say your life is a story full of diamonds, or your decision on what kind of fruit to eat in the summertime is a part of your trivia I learned after months of study. It's easy to rationalize any subject from one end of the spectrum to the other. LSD taught me this. And adopt every thought as fact. Anxiety taught me this. But I suppose for now the only truth I will adopt as religion is the fading daylight receding from my room, running to the edges of my walls, running away from me, and all sad things die in the shadows like secrets and graves. It's getting dark outside and soon we all must sleep. When death comes for friends, you can find me laying in green grass under blue sky, holding the white linen tapestry of my youth over my face to shield my eyes from the sun, where deep in the fabrics and fibers, stained pigments of faces recede against the light. Loving smiles I once cherished, slowly absorbed by death, one by one they fade, with each turn of the earth looking backwards at birth, reminding me of days that were full of gold and love, and I laugh at how stupid we were with fun. And I think of you one last time, before the moments are lost to memory, and I throw your dust in the wind. You see, I'm slowly losing my childhood to death, to time, the great thief, to that dark curtain that falls over us all. Yes, my friend, I will give you one last laugh and one last prayer, and I will remember how sweet you were with life, because tonight we will both close our eyes, but I will wake unto tomorrow as you fold into eternity. I am a burning lover, translating secret languages into a flower of fire, unfolding into transcendence petal by petal. You may call my name or turn my life into a song for the morning birds, a prayer for the silent ones who love to listen to the soft poetry of the wind. You may mold my heart with the delicate breath that breathed life into dust and cast stars across the sky like seeds in a royal garden. You may do all these things, my beloved, performing acts of greatness again and again for the sake of the world that my eager heart so desperately loves. Broken leaves fall against the back door of a teardrop forming at 3 a.m., taking the shape of rain, washing clean the dreams in my heart, watering thirsty flowers that seem to grow in my muscle fibers when thoughts of you appear, delicate as a ghost, clear as glass, silent as my soul. There is an equator that winds around my torso, separating the earthly from the spiritual. Wrapped between the third and fourth chakras, this mark bears all of my heartache and loneliness that rises to the surface of my skin when I arch my back and stretch. This is how I release you, by breathing and stretching, keeping the weather patterns of my spirit circulating through its atmosphere, ensuring sunlight and rain touch the parts of this life that truly matter.